Once a month, Bear couldn't sleep. He couldn't sleep because it was a full moon, and something about a full moon just wouldn't let him sleep. Something in him wanted to get out and have a party. And so that's what Bear decided to do.
I'm going to have a party, huh?
All his friends would come and they would dance because Bear loved to dance. He went to his friend's house and invited them one by one. And on the way, he made up a song that he was going to use at the party.
Come on out and play with me. Come on out now, can't you see? The moon will shine until it stays. So come on out and play. Come on out and play.
Stupid idea, said his brother. Ridiculous. No one's gonna come. Animals are too sensible for that sort of thing. No one wants to stay up all night like you do. They've never done it before. They'll never do it now.
Bear shook his head and said,
You never know what might happen, do you?
He talked to the dogs and the coyotes and the wolves.
Hey, you guys, come on out and play with me.
Oh, no way, bad idea, said Coyote. It'll never work. I'll do it, but you'll never get the other animals to come, especially my cousins, the dogs. They sleep inside all night. They don't do anything anymore except beg for doggy biscuits.
He didn't care. He talked to the moose.
Hey, moose, come on out and play with me.
Me? Said Moose. Me come to your party? I'm much too busy for that. More important things to do.
Nothing is more important than getting together to share.
Noble idea, but not very practical.
You never know what might happen, Moose.
And he went on and on, inviting one animal after another.
Come on out and play with me.
Well, all the birds agreed that they didn't want to stay up all night, since most of them had to work the next morning.
Never, they chirped. Forget it, no one will come.
Bear said,
You never know what might happen.
He talked to the crickets, the June bugs, and the bees.
Hey, come on out and play with me.
Buzz off, they all said.
Bear went home. His brother met him and said,
Hey, what's happening with your party? No one's coming, are they?
Bear said,
You never know. I'm having a party, even if only one animal comes. And I'm an animal, and I'm coming.
The night of the party, the sun went down. Bear stepped outside of his den into the clearing where the party was going to be. It grew darker and darker as Bear waited for someone to come. But no one came. Bear sat and waited, and still no one came. Finally, he sighed to himself.
Oh, they're all late. I guess the party will just have to start without them.
And Bear began to dance around the clearing, singing.
Come on out, play with me, huh? Come on out now, can't you see? The moon will shine until it's day. So come on out and play. Come on out and play.
Meanwhile, below ground, the fox family was trying to get their kids in bed. But the earth shook.
What's that shaking? Who's doing that? Listen to that noise up there. Who's making it?
They all piled out of the hole, only to find Bear right above them, singing and dancing.
Come on out and play with me.
Fox said, Oh, look at that bear. No one's at his party. He's still having it.
One of the kid foxes said, Yeah, and he's having a good time, too. And at that moment, who should come through the clearing but Wolf on his way to his cousin's house, Coyote. He saw Bear dancing in the clearing and the fox family watching.
Hey, he said, I forgot all about this party. Hiya, Fox. I'm kind of surprised to see you here. How come you're not dancing?
Fox said,
I'm just watching, really.
And Wolf sat down and watched. When Bear saw them, he kept dancing, but he said,
I'm glad you're here. You never know what might happen, do you? If you're hungry, there's refreshments in the house. I'm busy with the party.
And he went on dancing. All the noise woke up the moose, who had been bedded down for the night. He stomped into the clearing.
Excuse me, what is the meaning of this? I don't remember any party being mentioned.
This is my party, said Bear. I invited you, don't you remember?
Oh, your party. I'd forgotten. You probably like me to join in, wouldn't you?
And Moose came in on bass.
Boom, 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 boom.
Well, the singing and the dancing woke up the birds in the trees. They looked down and started to talk among themselves.
Look at that, will ya? People came. I would have planned on coming, but I didn't think it would work.
Well, we're up. It doesn't look like it's going to stop. We might as well check it out. Maybe there's something to eat.
And the birds flew down, and a quartet of sparrows sat on a branch right above Bear, who kept on singing.
Hey, Bear, they said, you want some help?
Sure, said Bear.
And the sparrows joined in.
Look out for the rabbits, yelled Bear,
because the rabbits were arriving by the dozens. Some of them had visited a nearby farm and brought along things for the vegetable plate. Bear started singing again, but before he could start to dance, the rabbits had filled up the dance floor, so Bear just sang along with the moose.
Boom, 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 boom.
And the birds.
Come on along and play with me. Come on now, now, can't you see?
Well, all this time, the crickets and their friends had been right outside the forest in the nearby field doing their work. But when they heard the noise, they hopped right over and joined in on percussion.
He said, one porcupine with everybody singing and dancing, how'd you get such a swinging party?
You never know what might happen, said Bear. I think it's because of the moon.
What moon?
That one, look.
And all the animals looked up, and for a moment, there was complete silence because the moon was full. It was so close to them, it seemed that it was hanging right there in the treetops, looking down.
Hello there, moon, said the bear. Nice night you picked to be full. Not too dark like some other nights.
And the moon rose just a little bit in the sky, and it turned ever so slightly, and it answered back, yes, Bear, nice night for a party. And it headed higher into the sky. The animals looked at the bear. They were speechless. Bear shrugged his shoulders.
You never know.
And then he started to sing and dance.
Come on out, play with me. Come on out, now can't you see? The moon will shine until it's day. Come on out, play. Come on out, play.
And everyone joined him. They danced all night. They ate all the food. They drank all the drinks. They danced until their paws were sore. And then they went and they danced some more. They danced until the moon had crossed the sky. And then one of the birds called out a new tune. And one by one, all the other birds began to call out louder and louder in a new song, a song that called the day.
Party's over, said Bear. Thanks for coming.
And he headed towards his den.
Hey, Bear, said Raccoon, what about the dishes and stuff? Aren't you going to clean it up?
Leave it. I'll do it later. It's my party.
And Bear went to bed. Well, Bear got up late that morning. He spent most of the day cleaning his house and sweeping the clearing. Later on, he stopped over at his brother's house.
Wow, said his brother, I've never seen anything like last night. All that dancing, all those animals, and the moon. No one has ever heard the moon speak before. Could you believe it?
Bear smiled and hummed.
You never know what might happen, do you? Come on out, play with me. Come on out, now can't you see? The moon will shine until it's day. So come on out and play. Come on out and play.